Hey guys and girls, welcome back to what is officially going to be called episode 2 of Can It Climb. As you guys would recognize, we have the Galivanter Baller updated edition. This one looks like it's a cross between a modern Range Rover and a Range Rover Evoque. Now, you guys would have seen this video in my Thanks a Lot Snow video, and thankfully, guys and girls, the snow is gone. But we are going to be shooting this one at night because I really don't think the daytime nighttime thing is going to have too much effect on how this vehicle is going to climb up Mount Chilliad. So without further ado, let's jump into it once again. Let's check out the interior. So you guys can see that we got some nice yellow dials, CD player, air conditioner, glove box. We also get some rear headrests and that lovely slender rear window at the back there. So visibility, it's not brilliant, but it's an SUV, as you guys can understand. Okay, that's the interior there. What we are going to do is, once again, climb Mount Chilliad following our predetermined track. It's not a set track. It's not one that's actually inside of GTA 5. It's one that I've made up to test absolutely every capability of the SUVs that we're going to be testing in this series. And we're just going to get rid of my assistant right there because I am now a CEO. So if you guys notice, I have a huge amount of money. That's because I bought a shark card. That's right. When I first signed up to Grand Theft Auto 5, they gave me an opportunity to get double the money on any shark card I bought. So I bought a $1.2 million shark card and I spent the $1.2 million on getting myself an office. And then they rewarded me with an additional $1.2 million. So that's what's sitting in my account now. Now, since the snow's gone, I can tell you guys now that the Galivanter, depending on how you pronounce it, the Galivanter Baller update, because there is two models, which I will bring you the second one in another video. And this is the updated version because this has the rounded curves and looks like, as I said, a more modern Range Rover Evoque or a Range Rover Sport. It's a combination of the two, really. But we are up here now and we are going to be doing our standardized testing for the vehicle. And here is our two little shrubs. And what we're going to do is we are going to test our flex. Here we go. Look at that. Look at the amount of flex we get off this wing. The rear wheel is pretty much outside of the rear wheel arch, and the front one is well up inside the guard. So that's pretty good flex for an SUV. Look at that. Not bad at all. So we're going to test its downhill descent control by dropping it literally off a vertical cliff. Here we go. Down we go. Nice and easy. Braking is pretty good for downhill. Not bad. Now let's test its approach angle. I just got to make sure the camera will cooperate. We're going to scrape going through our little creek. Oh yeah, that nose has definitely gone into the ground. And because there is such a huge amount of bodywork behind the rear wheel, we have dragged our tail. So the approach angle at the front is okay. It's pretty good. Not much bodywork in front of the front wheel, but that rear departure angle is pretty bad. Look at that. We're actually scraping. So, see, look at that. We're scraping our back end as we go through there. And then we make our way up the hill. And we begin our climb on the Mount Chilliad ascent. As I said, this is not a predetermined course, guys. It's not part of a race or anything. It's just a course I've made up to test out the SUVs. So we come up to here. We then turn onto the trail and make our way up. There's several steep sections, so it'll test the engine's torque, the handling, because the corners are quite sharp. Now, there is some extreme off-road sections, but we already know these vehicles cannot climb them, so we don't bother. There is a small one up the top, which we'll test our approach angle on, but as I said, it's going to be pretty much the same. So you guys get a rough idea of what I think of each vehicle after I test them. Okay, so here we go, up we go. Now this is the problem we had, this is the area we had problems with in the snow. And as you can see, straight on up, no problems whatsoever. So without the snow, we've got plenty of grip. And as you can see, we are making our way up Mount Chilliad. There's a parachute for us to use in case we have to jump off. I'm hoping we don't have to. Now, on our way down, we will be making those descents so we can test out the durability of the vehicle. But up we go. Now, the turning circle on this one, not pin sharp. In the dry, it's not bad, but it's not exactly pin sharp. Good thing is it doesn't feel low down on torque. It feels actually quite powerful. Whoa. And up we go. See, I can floor it, we get some speed. Now here's that little one we're going to test our approach angle on. Okay, let's see how we go. Now as you can see, there's not much bodywork in front of that front wheel. So that's a good approach angle sign. It means that the front wheel should grab grip and lift the front end up. But I'm a bit afraid that our wheelbase is a little long, so our ramp over angle won't be as good. So let's see how we go. Here we go. Front end grips, and up we go. Nah, that wheelbase is causing us a problem. So the approach angle is good, but the ramp over not so good, and that departure angle at the back is pretty big. Righto, up we go. So I can't do that one there, which is more reserved for the more extreme off-roaders. Still, not too bad, not too bad. As I said, it feels a little bit different now I'm driving it in the dry compared to when I was driving it in the snow. It feels good on power. Feels like it will pull its way up the mountain, no problems at all. Now, this is unmodded, guys and girls. This is just as you find them on the street. I have not done anything to it. Because what would be the point of doing a stock vehicle test if I didn't tell you about the mods? There are no mods. So, okay, here we go. We're going to begin our long journey up to the summit. So, let's go. Feels quite nimble, actually. Does feel quite sporty. No shortness on power. Alright, now we get to the tricky bit right at the very summit. Can we get to the very summit in the Galivanter Baller update? Ready? Here we go. Up the first set of steps. Ooh. Around the corner. Up the second set of steps. Whoop. Lifting wheels. Grab some grip. Come on. Okay, well, I didn't make it the first time up. Let's see if we can back her down and try again. Come on, get some grip. Let's go. I have to admit, a longer wheelbase did hamper it coming up to the summit, but we're up. Let's have a quick look at the damage and see what we've copped. Overall, it doesn't look like it's got too much damage. Our lights are still shining. Got a bit of a bump to the front nose. Bit of a bump. Camber does look to be a little bit out on the front end, but that could be from where the vehicle is resting. But it looks like that front shock has copped a bit of a bump, bit of a hiding. Okay, so all in all, bodywork is not too bad. So it survived the trip up with minimal damage. Now, as you guys know, what goes up must go down. So here we go. We're going to get it off the summit the same way we brought it up. Oh, body panel grinding, but we're out. Here we go. Down. Down we go. Let's test the engine braking. It's not too bad, it's controllable. It's not too bad at all, actually. do have to use the brakes because we do get a bit of speed, but it's not bad. It's controllable. And look, the sun's coming up just as we're completing it. That's cool. Give it a bit of berries up through here. For those of you who don't know what it means by giving it berries, it means put your foot down on the accelerator and drive it. Okay, let's see how we go downhill. Now this is a $90,000 SUV, which means basically if you see one on the street, you can steal it and stick it in your garage. So that's a good thing, because it's underneath the 100,000 limit. Here we go, round we go. The turning circle's not bad. I have to admit, some of the other SUVs I've brought down here have been pretty bad. This one's not bad at all, actually. Let's just pull over here, switch to the camera view. Let's see how we go. Alright, here we go. Off the drop-off in first person view. And down we go. Ready? Bump, slide, crunch. Ooh, pivot, roll. Ah! Oh dear. We lost a door. Door sliding out from underneath us. But other than that, it didn't do too bad. I mean, the body shape is still intact. That was more my fault than anything. So, gonna give it points for structural integrity. I mean, the doors did fly open and we did peel the door off, but eh. That's to be expected. Here we go, straight off the long drop. And down we go. Oh, there's a tree there. Not bad. Not bad at all, actually. Here we go. Pretty good, actually. All in all, I'm very impressed with the Galivanter Baller Update Edition. Because, as I said, there is another edition that looks like a Range Rover Discovery 3. Okay, we're going off the big bit down here. Ready? And off we go. Nice and slow. Here we go. Vertical drop. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. Oh, there's a hiker. Hope he doesn't swear at us. Nope, we're good. And down we go. Well, see, without the snow, everything is so much better. The vehicles drive so much better. The grip is great. I'm going to go down here. Here comes a train. Big important tip, guys and girls, don't try and challenge a train. You will lose every time. Let's take you through a bit of a rough bit here. And back over to the bridge. And back to the sawmill where we began. Alrighty, guys and girls, I have to admit, the Galivanter Baller update, this is the update one, because there is the older class, this one is pretty damn good. Okay, it's pretty durable. I did roll it on its roof at a fairly high altitude. The body shape itself is still in really good condition. There's not that much damage to the panels underneath. Okay, we did lose the glass and a door, but that's okay, that's minor. It feels really good as far as power is concerned, just standard. It feels like it has got a pretty good amount of torque. Pulls you up the hill, no problems whatsoever. Grip is a little bit hit and miss. If you launch this thing hard on that mountain, you're just going to sit there and spin the wheels. You've got to feather the throttle on. Makes it really hard if you own a keyboard, but I'm using an Xbox 360 controller, so it was pretty easy to feather the throttle on and power it up the hill. But guys and girls, I will say, if you can find one of these on the streets of Grand Theft Auto 5 in Los Santos or up in Sandy Shores or wherever, Palito Bay, doesn't matter where you can find one. If you can find one, nab one, stick it in your garage and then modify it. Alrighty guys and girls, that has been the Galivanter Baller update. And until next time, guys and girls, I am gonna say bye for now. Don't forget to, like, comment, subscribe, share. And until next time, I'll say bye for now.